Can I share my slides?
Yes, please.
Okay. So is it visible?
Yes, visible.
Okay. So thank you, friends. So for the next 20 minutes, I'll be talking on pollution and heart. But as you know, there are many different types of pollution. There are air pollution, water pollution, soil pollution, radioactive pollution, and there are so many types of pollution. But I'll be, because of the scarcity of time, I'll concentrate on air pollution only. So air pollution and cardiovascular disease. Okay, sorry. So coming to air pollution, what is air pollution? What are the composition, chemistry, and sources of air pollution? As you know, air pollution is a mixture of particulate matter, gases that ranging in size from a few nanometers to several micrometers, and gaseous co-pollutants that can exist in a particulate phase. So it includes particulate and gaseous primary pollutants such as nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, which are released directly into the atmosphere, as well as the secondary pollutants such as ozone that are formed at the atmosphere. You know, ozone is definitely a protective one in the higher status, but in the lower status, if there is ozone, again, that is a definitely health hazard. So air pollution includes both ambient or outdoor pollution and household or indoor pollution. Ambient air pollution arises principally from fossil fuel combustion and pollutants released in the atmosphere from stationary sources such as coal-fired power plants, steel mills, and from mobile sources like cars, trucks, ships are the principal contributors to the ambient air pollution. In the low-income countries, the household air pollution is caused mainly by the combustion of biomass fuels, wood, coal, stone, and charcoal in home cook stoves, and disproportionately affects women and children. So in high-income countries, sources of household air pollution include natural gas combustion, wood burning stoves, fireplaces, incense, candles, and aerosol stuff, and so on. But you see, when we talk of air pollution, there is a measure how to measure. Which are the air quality index? When we go for air quality index, that particularly measures the particulate matters. This is very important. This is mostly studied. So what is that particulate matter? Particulate matter is the most thoroughly studied component of air pollution and is strongly linked to multiple health effects. And it is categorized to coarse particles that are less than 10 micrometers, and fine particles that are less than 2.5 micrometers, and ultra fine particles that are less than 0.1 micrometers. So multiple studies also link gaseous pollution, most notably ozone, to increase the morbidity and mortality. This is just to so a picture where you can just compare, because this is the hair. This hair, human hair, is also 50 to 75 micrometer in diameter here. So if you see PM10, so it is just like this, the dust, pollen, mold. So these are all PM10. And if you see PM2.5, this is the combustion particles by organic compounds, metals like that. So these are very, very important. I will be talking about PM2.5-10 repeatedly. So that's why this is called PM10 and PM2.5. According to WHO, the daily acceptable level of PM, it is, they see PM2.5 is 10 microgram per meter cube, that is cubic millimeter annual mean, and 25 microgram per cubic millimeter is 24 hour mean. Whereas in PM10 is 20 microgram and annual mean is 50 microgram. This is the acceptable WHO status. But whereas in Indian standards, this is less stringent. You see, the PM2.5 is, they take 40 instead of 10. Annual mean is 60, here is only 25. And PM10 is 60, and this is 20, and this is 100, that is annual mean 100 in place of 50. So in the Indian standards are less stringent in case of this particular matter. But the boron, burden of air pollution, mediated morbidity and mortality, you see the global burden study estimates that pollution was responsible for 9 million deaths worldwide in 2019, and out of which 61% of which are due to cardiovascular disease, including ischemic heart disease, that is 31% and stroke is 27%. Again, who estimates that 91% of the world's population resides in places where the annual mean air pollution exceeds the WHO guideline of 10. That means almost all over the world, every citizen is in the area of air pollution. You see, this is the picture. Here you can see the global cardiovascular disease and mortality. You see, the India and China, they lead the whole world. That is, here the standard death per 1 lakh is almost 80 to 175 per lakh due to air pollution only. And these are the mortality different diseases. You see, cardiovascular disease, that this is the most most of the diseases are due to cardiovascular disease. And that is a chronic pulmonary disease, cancers beyond that. But again, out of this CVD, this ischemic heart disease almost is 50%, and rest of this stroke and hypertension. These are due to only air pollution. And you see, if you compare the global pollution and the China pollution and the Indian pollution, and in the, this is the United States, see, again, India leads. Always, like any other problem, India is also the leader. And the if you see the exposure response in the relationship between PM25, here is you can see also the stroke and ischemic heart. As you the more and more of PM25 pollution, there is more and more of ischemic heart disease and stroke. So these are the global burden that is been found in globally and also in Indian scenario. Here you see the contribution of air pollution versus other risk factors. If you see all other risk factors beyond air pollution, be it smoking, be it malaria, be it alcohol abuse, be it malnutrition, whatever may be, but you see the mortality for air pollution is almost transferred among all the risk factors. So friends, in India, around 1.2 million deaths, that is 12.5% of total deaths, were attributed to air pollution in 2017, and around 60% is from ambient PM pollution and 40% from this household air pollution. In 2019, it increases to 1.7 million deaths, which occurs 17.8%. So just imagine what is the real burden of this air pollution and in which we are now moving in India. So air pollution due to PM10 is mainly because of dust from industries, mining and construction, whereas pollution from PM2.5 is combustion and burning of fossil fuel and biomass stubble burning after harvesting these paddy crops. You know, this is the really havoc in Delhi area. So we must have all felt. You see, this is the what I want to show you. This is the Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, where the population where this PM2.5 is almost more than 100. And here these are the areas where this proportion of population is in more and more solid fuel. So cardiometabolic effects of air pollution. The emerging research suggests that air pollution from different sources, such as vehicular exhaust, industrial emission, and coal smoke, may differ with respect to health risks, reflecting variations in the chemical composition, toxic metal content, and oxidative potential. The traffic-related air pollution, which is a major threat, contains large quantities of ultrafine particles, which may contribute disproportionately to cardiovascular toxic effect. Again, coming to if there are problems, if there are comorbid conditions, biology factors such as advanced age, prior cardiovascular disease, cardiovascular risk factors, pulmonary disease, so immunosuppression, so these people, again, they are more susceptible to air pollution. And the death is more within this subset of population. And recent data support an interaction between air pollution and increased mortality from coronavirus, COVID-19. This pandemic also, they have found out in between air pollution where the PM10 or PM2.5 is high, then there this COVID-19 death is also high in this area of the globe. Now, climate change, high temperature exacerbates the adverse effects of air pollution on health through multiple cascading mechanisms. Now, coming to the cardiovascular disease, you see, it has been found the short-term variations in PM22.5 levels from hours to days even. That is also associated with increased risk of myocardial infarction, stroke, and death from cardiovascular disease. So if somebody is exposed to PM22.5 very high level only for a short period, maybe for a few days, then also this risk of cardiovascular disease again goes up. And the risk of these events increases by 0.1% for each short-term increment of 10 microgram per cubic meter in the PM2.5 level. Prospective cohort studies also support a robust causal association between longer-term PM2.5 exposure and elevated mortality from ischemic heart disease. Increase of 16 to 31% for each increment of 10 microgram per cubic meter in annual mean PM2.5 exposure are reported across a wide range of concerns. So you can just imagine our factors in India. A meta-analysis of 35 studies showed that each increment in the PM2.5 level of 10 microgram per cubic meter was associated with a 2.12% increase in the risk of hospitalization or death from heart failure, with the strongest association involving increased pollution level on the day of exposure. And air pollution has also been associated with increases of atrial fibrillation and ventricular arrhythmias and sudden cardiac death. Ambient PM2.5 pollution has been causally linked to the multiple risk factors for cardiovascular disease, most notably hypertension and also diabetes. So these are the things why India, China, they also lead the whole world in terms of the incidence of hypertension and diabetes also. So on average, an increase in PM2.5 exposure of 10 microgram per cubic meter during the preceding day increases systolic and diastolic blood pressure by 0.5 to 1 milliliters mercury with a wide range of response, and some persons elevations as high as 5 to 10 millimeters mercury. Long-term exposure is associated with increased cardiac endothelial thickness, coronary artery calcification, abdominal aortic calcification, and also LVH, progression of chronic kidney disease. In addition, evidence from clinical, epidemiologic, and experimental studies also link PM25 exposure to insulin resistant type 2 diabetes. So globally, airborne PM2.5 pollution is estimated to contribute to about 3.2 million incident cases of diabetes each year. So again, air pollution is also related to diabetes and hypertension, which are the risk factors for again cardiovascular disease. What are the mechanism of this cardiovascular disease? Again, the mechanism through which pollution is caused, CVD, are complex and varied, and that this can be initiating mechanisms, effector pathways, and risk factor development. And initiating mechanism occurs at the locus of initial exposure. They include inflammation, activation of neural reflex arc, and ligation of pattern recognition receptors. And effect mechanism, this is what pattern recognition, so you know, these are of innate immune system because they immediately take over these particular matters. And effector mechanism include activation of rapid neural pathways and release of biologically active intermediates, that is inflammatory cytokines, oxidized lipids, immune cells, macrophages, and microRNAs. You see, these are the secondary effect pathways: endothelial barrier dysfunction, inflammation, prothrombic pathways, autonomic imbalance, central nervous system, and effect on metabolism and HPA-XC activation, and also epigenomic changes. There are found to be this increased methylation of DNA also. So the development of risk factor for cardiovascular disease such as hypertension and type 2 diabetes is a late stage event, resulting from chronic pollution and induced oxidative stress and inflammation. These mechanisms underlie the increase in blood pressure after exposure to air pollution, and lead part involve reduction mediated into alteration in vascular artery. So friends, persistent inflammation and endocrine dysfunction also that can lead to insulin resistance. Prolonged exposure also that can be found to be transcriptional epigenetic programming. So this is what I have described all the pathways. You can be mainly these oxidative stress and inflammation. They are the main mechanisms that leads to, again, endothelial dysfunction and the systemic inflammation. So these are the various factors that has been found to be the mechanisms. It is a very complex mechanisms. So coming to strategies, how to mitigate this cardiovascular effects of air pollution. So this is insert, this is algorithm. We can go patient-centered strategies, and we can then societal and governmental strategies. Patient-centered strategies, you see the hazards, Delhi PM, you have to see the air quality index. You can just go through the apps and you can find how to measure this air quality index. So that shows what is the really what is the most particulate matter concentration. So PM 2.5 more than 300, definitely you have to use mask, stay indoors most of the time. But if it is less than that, if you are more, if you have what, if you are a susceptible patient, then again you have to adhere to these principles. Otherwise, if you are not susceptible, it is less than that, then you can have a normal life. Issue the societal and governmental strategies. There are various strategies that I'll come the next slide. This is what issue, what are the social and governmental interventions that is shifting to clean fuel, transportation reforms, reduced traffic emission, urban landscape reform, emission trading programs, redirection of science and funding, empowering civil society and governmental and NGO fed publicity. So this should be taken by the social and governmental agencies. But coming to the personal interventions, face masks and air purifiers, and reducing traffic exposures, reducing home penetration of outdoor air pollution, and lifestyle changes and prevention medicine, that has to be taken personally. So that if you can take all these measures, we can prevent cardiovascular disease. It's more, again, people who are more susceptible, then they should be more cautious while being exposed to the air pollution in different cities. So friend, to summarize, recognition of pollution as a major cardiovascular risk factor is often overlooked in clinical practice. We physicians, whenever we get these patients, we never ask the patients about the air pollution exposure. Because though it is definitely a risk factor, so we have to take care of this. And understanding of the role of pollution can also guide physicians, medical societies, public health authorities, environmental agencies, health insurers, and governments in developing evidence-based strategies for preventing cardiovascular disease that link pollution prevention with the control of behavioral and metabolic risk factors. Thank you.